This is the mounting template instruction video for the 240-260 EIM replacement system. We've gone through a few takes, so you're going to see some cutouts already made and some marks already made, but we'll get the point. Your original panel was set up with mounting studs. So you're not going to see any screws here, but you remove your original panel by removing the nuts on the back side. Don't have to worry about removing your keypad or your touchpad. You are going to have to disconnect some wires, and you're going to have to cut the wires for the indicator light if you have one. You also have to disconnect the plug connector for the peanut pad, but then the whole assembly will come out. This particular panel, the mounting studs have been removed already, but that's where they would be placed, where you see those silver circles. So once this is removed, your dash panel will look very similar to this. It won't have the scribe lines, of course. That's what we make with the mounting template. So your panel set and EIM system came with mounting template instructions and a cardboard mounting template. You're going to mount that or place that mounting template, line it up with the different holes, and tape it in place. Line it up with the holes and tape it in place. Try not to tape over the mounting screw holes, because what we're going to be doing with our new system is going to have traditional mounting screws, and you are going to be drilling mounting holes into your fiberglass. You can also use a dowel or a screwdriver and use these stud positions here, and that will help you mount that template in the correct position. It's really not that difficult. Once it's mounted into position, there's a thin line scribed, and you're going to take a razor knife and you are going to cut that area out just like this and remove this center piece. Take a Sharpie and mark inside your template line. And then also remember to mark your screw hole positions. And you can go ahead and you can drill your mounting holes right through the template. Just try not to destroy the template, just in case you have to put it back on to clear up some lines. Once all of that is drilled, you're going to remove your mounting template. And this is the line you're going to use your jigsaw to cut out clearance for your new EIM replacement system. We also recommend drilling holes in the corners, and this will make it an easier entry and exit for your jigsaw rather than trying to make a corner. And here are your mounting screw locations. Once this is removed from your fiberglass panel, you're ready for your installation.